हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई विल टॉकिंग अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रैक स्टोमेटिव। इन दिस वी कैन सी डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ ट्रैक स्टोमेटिव इज द आउटर कैनुला, इनर कैनुला, ऑब्टूरेटर। डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ आउटर कैनुला आर नेक फ्लैंग, यू कैन सी नेक फ्लैंग हियर, ट्यूब शाफ्ट, कॉफ, इन्फ्लेशन लाइन, पायलट बेलून, पायलट पॉट विद द बॉल। Through this opening, we can insert air into the pilot balloon and it will help in inflating the cough. It is a 15 mm connector which helps to connect the tracheostomy tube with the ventilator. And neck flange has two opening. You can see these are the opening in the neck flange which helps to tie your rope around the neck, which prevent the displacement of the tracheostomy tube. Different types of tracheostomy tubes are available. Among them, one is coughed and uncoughed tube. You can see this is a cough tube and this is the uncoughed tube. Double cough tube, this is a single cough tube and this is a double cough tube. In double cough tube, each cough can be inflated alternately to prevent the pressure necrosis at one side of the trachea. Fenestration tube, this is the fenestration tube. You can see fenestration here, and in this also you can see fenestration here. Single or multiple holes are situated in the upper curvature. The hole help in speech production or in weaning from the tracheostomy. Fenestrated tube is used in children for decannulation. Adjustable flange long tube. These are the adjustable flange long tube. Extra length tracheostomy tubes are used when pre-tracheal tissues are thicker or swollen or to bypass a growth or stenosis in trachea. This tube can be used in obese patient. Flange in these cases is movable and fixed at a desired place according to the thickness of tissue in the neck. Single lumen tube. In this tube, there will be no inner cannula. These are the single lumen tube with the obturator. We can see obturator also. This is a single lumen tube. Double lumen tube. This is the outer cannula. This is inner cannula and this is obturator. Double lumen tube have an inner cannula inside outer cannula. It is easier to remove, clean and replace the inner cannula, keeping outer cannula in place for breathing. Suction aided tracheostomy tube. It is like an ordinary cough tracheostomy tube but also has a suction tube which reaches above the cough. This is the suction tube. It helps to suck out pharyngeal secretion collected above the cough. Suction should always be done before deflating the cough so that accumulated pharyngeal secretion do not get aspirated into the trachea. Tracheostomy with the speaking valve. A valve is fitted at the outer end of tracheostomy tube. It will allow the ingress of air when breathing in but closes when breathing out. While breathing out, the air finds its way to vocal cord to produce sound. It is used in long-term treatment of bilateral abductor paralysis or laryngeal stenosis. Digital closure of tracheostomy tube to speak is thus avoided. Classification of tube according to the material they are made of. Tracheostomy tube may be made of silver. And alloy of silver, copper and phosphorus, for example Fuller's tube, Negus or Jackson's tube, polyvinyl chloride tube, they are disposable single use tube and thermolabile and thus adjust to tracheal lumen, silicon tube, bacteria and secretions do not adhere to the tube and there is minimum of crusting. Siliconized polyvinyl chloride tube It has the property of both polyvinyl chloride and silicon. That is, it is thermolabile and adjusts to tracheal wall, while silicon prevents the crusting. Silastic tube, it is soft and non-irritating and minimizes the crusting. Armored tube, they are plastic tube reinforced by a spiral or ring of stainless steel. They are not easily kinked. Now, Fuller's bivalve tracheostomy tube. Then parts of Fuller's bivalve tracheostomy tube are biflanked outer tube. This is the outer tube and these are the flanks. And the collar is present to tie the rope. This is the collar and this is the opening where you can tie a rope. Inner tube. This is the inner tube. It has a circular ring, two gaps. Remove and insert the tube. This is the circular ring, two gaps. Remove and insert the tube. It is a metallic tracheostomy tube and has a inner tube that is longer than the biflanked outer tube. The inner tube is longer than the biflanked outer tube. This prevents the outer tube from getting blocked by secretions. The inner tube can easily be removed for cleaning. Also, the posterior wall of the inner tube has an opening that permits the patient to breathe through the nose and phonation. The two flanks of the outer tube can be compressed for initial introduction into the trachea. Hence, a pilot is not necessary for introduction. The compressed flanks of the outer tube hold the inner tube in place and prevent it from getting coughed out. Hence, a lock system is not required in this tube. Disadvantages: the tip of the flanks can injure the tracheal wall. Flanks can break after long use and present as foreign bodies. There is a risk of granulation tissue formation. Another is Jackson tracheostomy tube. Different parts of Jackson tracheostomy tube are inner tube. It is outer tube which contains a collar and a locking mechanism. This is for a locking mechanism and a pilot obturator. This consists of longer inner tube and outer tube. The inner tube is locked at the opening of the tube so that it is not coughed out. This is due to the pressure being built up as it does not have the inner tube opening. There are also flanks to hold the inner tube in place. There is a pilot for introduction of the tube into the trachea so that injury is not caused to the posterior wall. This is the lock system which is used to lock the inner tube. Disadvantages: phonation is not possible. The patency of the natural air passage cannot be checked by blocking the tube. There is a risk of granulation tissue formation. French gauze is 3 times the outer diameter of the tube. This French gauze system is commonly followed for identifying the number of metal tracheostomy tube. And this metal tracheostomy tube can be placed for longer time. So the patient with who need tracheostomy tube for longer time, the polyvinyl chloride tracheostomy tube is replaced with the metallic tube. And patient can be sent home in this tube and patient can be seen in follow-up. Non-metallic tube, the Protex tracheostomy tube, it is made up of polyvinyl chloride. Different parts of Protex tracheostomy tube are single tube with a collar. The single tube with a collar, it has a cuffed and it may also be available without a cuff. Balloon with valve of air and pilot obturator. We can see the pilot obturator which has inserted inside this tracheostomy tube. Advantages: it is made up of soft material, hence less damaging to the tracheal wall. Since it has a cuff, it is particularly useful for for intensive care unit patient. It is useful during radiotherapy. It has a blue radio opaque line all along the tube for radiological detection of the side of the tube. We can see the blue radio opaque line here. Disadvantages: cleaning the tube is more difficult as it requires the removal of the tube. Phonation is not usually possible. Checking the patency of natural airway is not possible. Cough might injure the tracheal wall, which means tracheal necrosis, if overinflated and left for a longer period of time. Pressure should be preferably less than 30 mm of Hg. The inner diameter in millimeters corresponds to the designated size of the tracheostomy tube. In this, the phonation is not usually possible because there is no fenestration in the tube, and if we close the outer opening of the tracheostomy tube, patient will feel difficulty in breathing. And for checking of the patency of the nasal airway passage, also we need the fenestration here, but it does not have a fenestration in this tube. But fenestrated tube are also available. Comparison between metallic and non-metallic tracheostomy tube are: this is the metallic tube and this is the non-metallic tracheostomy tube. Inner tube and outer tube is present in metallic tracheostomy tube, but for non-metallic tracheostomy tube only one tube is present. Cough is absent in metallic tube, but it may be present or absent in non-metallic tracheostomy tube. Positive pressure ventilation is not possible in metallic tracheostomy tube due to the absence of cough, but it is possible in non-metallic tracheostomy tube if the tracheostomy tube has a cough. Prevention of aspiration is not possible due to absence of cough, but it is possible in non-metallic tracheostomy tube if cough is present. Radiotherapy, metallic tracheostomy tube is incompatible, but the non-metallic tube is compatible. Phonation is possible for Fuller's type, but it is usually not possible in non-metallic tracheostomy tube as they usually has no fenestration. Cleaning the tube, it is simpler and easier as we can remove the inner tube in metallic tracheostomy tube, but in non-metallic tracheostomy tube it requires the removal of entire tube for cleaning. So comparison between the Fuller's and Jackson type tracheostomy tube: in Fuller's type tracheostomy tube, the outer tube is biflanked. In Jackson type, there is no flanks. Lock for inner canal, inner tube is absent for Fuller's tracheostomy tube, but it is present in Jackson tracheostomy tube. Bend for breathing and phonation on inner tube is present in Fuller's tracheostomy tube, but it is absent in Jackson tracheostomy tube. Pilot for introduction is absent in Fuller's tracheostomy tube, but it is present in Jackson tracheostomy tube. How to select the size of endotracheal tube in a children? The size of the tube in children is calculated with the formula S by 4 plus 4, which gives the inner diameter in mm. Length of the tube can be calculated by size of the tube into 3, and it gives the reading in centimeter. For example, in a 4-year child, by using this formula, we can see that 5 mm tube is suitable for this patient. And roughly the size of the tube is size of the child's little finger. Now, how to select a tube in adult? The tracheostomy tube for adult is selected by the size of the tube. Larger the size, greater is the inner diameter. In adult tubes of inner diameter varying between 6 and 9 or 10 mm is used. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.